It is truly an honor to bestow this award on such a deserving individual.
So I don't have a speech per se, but I just want to share a couple thoughts. And I thought I would share a little bit about maybe the journey and how I got here. There are many things I love about associations, and there are obvious ones. The obvious ones of the experiences that we've had, and certainly Allison and I have been very blessed with the people that we've been surrounded by and the relationships we've created. And, you know, other than joining the Navy, I don't think I could have done 100 international trips in the last 25 years. I mean, there are things that you have opportunities to do that would have never been available to me anywhere else. I think I appreciate much more now than I did 10 or 5 years ago even, is the diversity of the people. And the fact that the association community creates opportunities for people from wherever they're from, women, minorities, members of the LGBT community. The association world is welcome and is opening. Diversity is a strength, and it should be celebrated, and it should be lifted up. It's not a weakness that's diminished and denigrated. And that's one of the things I love about the association world, is that we embrace diversity, and we recognize that diverse organizations are more successful, and we certainly try to do that at the NRF every single day. And I guess the third thing is just simply the opportunity to have an impact. And the obvious impact that we talk about and the scorecard that we use to measure success is advocacy, and that's the number one job, as the old Ford commercial was, it's job number one, and we never forget that. There are things that associations do every single day that have nothing to do directly with advocacy. Maybe indirectly we can connect the dots, that's why we do some of these things, but a lot of them are just things that make our country and our communities better places. And that's why associations have an impact, and that's, I guess that's the reason I really love being at an association. It's a platform. The industry is a platform. Use it as a platform. And that's a lesson that I've taken to heart, and I think about it as a platform. So when we deliver messages, we try to lean into the platform of the retail industry, not be constrained by whether we have 12 million or 27 million or now 65 million. It doesn't matter, because as I said before, there's never enough. 250 million isn't enough. You always want more. Scale is a good, in my view, it's a good thing. But if you don't have scale, you still have a platform, and you have to use it the right way. Doc Cohen was the chairman of the board at the Franchise Association, and I think, Don, he probably had every job you could have at the IFA. He's chair of the Finance Committee, chair of the Franchisee Advisory Council, chair of the Foundation. And unfortunately, he's a very successful franchisee, lives in Houston. Doc taught me a lot of things over the years while he was on our board at the IFA. And at an event like this one, in his honor, some years ago, he came off the stage after being recognized. And I said, Doc, congratulations on all your successes. And he said, Matthew, the last thing I did by myself was hire my first employee. Everything after that I've done as a team. An enormously successful guy. And Doc was still humble enough to recognize that he didn't do any of it by himself. He did it with his team, and it began with the first step he took when he hired his first employee. So that's a lesson I try not to forget. And if you can do what's best for the association and put that first and foremost and not think about your parochial little piece of it, you can be successful. It's not about the little piece of what you do, it's about the big picture. And as much of a superstar, rock star you think you might be in your little area, that piece alone isn't enough to get it done. You get to do it. You get to do this. Whatever it is you do, you get to do it. I get to be the CEO of this great successful trade association, but there are things we all do in our lives, in our work lives, in our private lives, that I think sometimes cause us to, for a minute maybe, think, I can't believe I have to do this. And I think a lot of life is, I get to do this. And looking at it that way, you know, makes a big difference. The road not taken thing, the Robert Frost poem, I think is a little tricky. Robert Frost wrote that poem really for a friend, an Englishman who was a poet, who always agonized over his decisions and second-guessed everything and thought about the road that he hadn't taken. And we all think of it as the road not taken poem. The poem is actually called A Walk in the Woods. And the joke is that Frost thought, if you're going to take a walk in the woods, you get to do it. It's just a walk in the woods. Don't worry about it. It's going to be fine. What I would say to this next generation of association leaders that we saw up here today is I hope that for you, I hope that you'll find the association field as diverse and rewarding and challenging and fulfilling as I have. And I hope for us, we get to keep doing this for a very, very long time, because I do love what I get to do and the people I get to do it with. And I hope for all of you that you'll recognize that you get to do it and that you enjoy the walk. So thank you all very much.